Welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Finding dates is just a weird thing in Excel. You have to match the format exactly. I had someone who sent in a note. He said that he recorded a macro that found the 30th of a particular date. And when he played that macro back, it was giving him a debug error. So that's macro 2 here. I'll run that. Object variable with block not set. And when I looked into this, the day that he happened to record the macro, his dates must have been formatted with 2 digits for the month. And now the dates are formatted with a single digit for the month. And that causes Excel to not find a match. Isn't that frustrating? But that's the way that Edit Find works when we're looking for formatted numbers or formatted date. And what's frustrating with this is, you know, when you run that macro, there may be data where that date isn't found. And so I said, you know, rather than use the macro recorder, why don't we go through and just use a completely different approach, And basically, so what this macro does is it says we have a data set and it's going to find the final row and the final column, basically by going to the last row, hitting the N key and pressing up. So we'll see that in this particular case, final row. Final row is 308 and final column is 7. All right. So what we do then is set up some criteria. So the criteria column is 2 plus my final row. And I build a little criteria section there, basically copying the date from cell A1 over to I1, and I enter 9/30/2008, click OK, and that gets entered in Excel. Then I set up an output range. The output range is going to be all of the headings from the original data set. So here's my input range, A through G. Here's my criteria range in column I, and then my output range in K through Q. And now I'm going to use a function that most of us don't use in the Excel interface, but it's a very powerful function called Advanced Filter. It's one line of code. Basically, we're going to do a advanced filter, doing an Excel filter copy, specifying the criteria range. And when we do that, what we're going to see is that we get from the original data set just the dates that fall on the date that we input. So there's 9/30/2008. Clear out the criteria range, cut the output range, and then add a brand new workbook and paste, doing an auto fit. And what we should see is now we have the records in a brand new workbook for 9/30/2008. And the way that this works is it's a bit more generic in that if we ask for a date that's not there, it's still going to keep running. It's not going to give us any sort of an error. We're just going to get a blank workbook without any records at all. So using advanced filter is a bit more friendly than using find. We don't have to worry about how that data is formatted out there in column A. The filter is actually looking at the underlying value, and it's going to work every single time. Well, there you have it. A better way to find dates within a data set. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.